nutritionality. Last week's episode was a little long, so I'm going to try to keep today a little shorter and sweeter. We're going to do overnight oats. So overnight oats is kind of a newer trend in the last few years. I believe people have probably been soaking grains overnight for generations, but it's something that sort of has come up more recently. So I don't know, you've probably heard of them. If you haven't, I don't know where you've been. There's tons of ways to make overnight oats. I'm going to show you one that just happens to be about 400 calories. Okay, so you got to get started with some oats. Here are my ingredients. Oats, chia seeds. You can do overnight oats without chia seeds. I think they really add something. Chia seeds, when you soak them, they really like expand in volume and they create almost like a gel. So it really can improve the consistency of your dish. They add additional benefits as well. They're a source of polyunsaturated fat, which I may talk a bit about later. I really love strawberries in oats, in oatmeal. So I've got frozen strawberries. They're in my freezer. I'm going to pull them out in just a moment so we can cut them. And then I use a little bit of banana. This is my sweetener. And then a little bit of walnuts. And then cinnamon, just for some spice. Okay, so the basics, here we go. I'm going to use a third of a cup of oats. I'm going to put it in a mason jar. I like these. These are, you know, they're cute. They're great because you can take them with you. You know, if you're going, and if you get up in the morning, you've made your oats the night before, get up in the morning, you don't have time to eat before you leave, grab the jar, eat them at work, eat them at school, eat them on your commute if you need to. But they're nice. But you can put this in a oatmeal bowl and just cover it and put it in the fridge overnight and then just eat it out of a bowl in the morning or any Tupperware container, totally fine, doesn't really matter. Before I put in the oats though, I'm going to do the banana and I'll show you why in a moment. So this is like an extra large banana. The USDA would consider this extra large. It's like 9 inches long. We're just going to use half of it. And I use this for my sweetener, so I don't have to use any sugar. No maple syrup, no honey, no stevia or anything like that. It adds good flavor, but it also adds the sweetness that I'm looking for. So I'm just going to break it in half. And then the other half is going to go probably in the freezer. I'll use it for something else later. And then I'm just going to pop it in the bottom of my jar and mash it. Oh, we're also using almond milk today. That's my liquid of choice. You can use regular milk if you want to. Some recipes call for yogurt. I just like using plain milk, and when I drink milk, I prefer to stick to non-dairy, but that's just a personal preference. You do what you want to do. And the almond milk is unsweetened, so again, this is really our only source of sweetening. I find it to be enough. And I just mash it up like you would mash bananas if you were making banana bread or something. So you want your banana to be kind of ripe to be able to do that. And this is just going to help it to mix in better. Now, we're going to use 1 cup of almond milk. Oh, and I didn't get my cup measure, of course. So I'm going to measure it now because I'm going to add a little bit of it to the banana so I can get that started mixing. I like to add the liquid a little bit at a time because otherwise if you try to add all the liquid at the end to the dry ingredients, it's really hard to stir it in this jar. So 1 cup of unsweetened almond milk, unsweetened. It should stay unsweetened or it will have sugar added. I'm just going to add a little bit. And then I'm going to add the dry ingredients. And I'm going to put most of this in on the top at the end. But I want to get that going. Okay, and then I'm going to add my dry ingredients. So now I'm going to put in my oats. A third of a cup of oats. A third of a cup of oats has about 100 calories. So I think that's a good portion. You know, obviously once this is dry, these are rolled oats. So don't use instant or quick cook oats. Those are processed a little bit more. And again, you're better with less processing. Not that rolled oats aren't processed. They are, but they don't grow out of the ground flat like that. But it's less processed. Okay, so then chia seeds. We're going to use a tablespoon of chia seeds. And then I'm going to also throw in the cinnamon. You don't really have to worry as far as calories are concerned when it comes to like spices. First of all, you use a very little of them. And secondly, they just don't contribute that much. So I never do. Sometimes I'll throw in a dash of salt. if you feel like you need that, you can do that, but I'm not going to do that right now. Okay, so I'm just going to mix those so that they're mixed together. I find if you wait till everything's added and mix it, you end up with clumps. It's harder to mix. So I kind of just do it little by little while there's room in the jar. Now I'm going to grab the strawberries. These are frozen strawberries I get from Trader Joe's. They're pretty affordable. A lot of these ingredients come from Trader Joe's. We keep our oats in an old coffee jar, but these are from Trader Joe's. The bananas are from Trader Joe's. I get as large a banana as I can when I shop at Trader Joe's because they sell them per, and so I'm going to get the most for my money. Okay, so I'm going to use 2/3 of a cup of strawberries. Now, frozen whole strawberries, kind of hard to measure 2/3 of a cup. So this is one of those situations where, like, you're never going to be exact. Don't worry about it. For me, I just need to make sure it's going to fit in a jar. But I'm going to chop them because if I don't, they're bigger than I like to eat them. If you like to eat whole strawberries in your oatmeal, then keep them whole. But I think, you know, they also are a little harder to stir if they're large. So that's about another third. So this is about 2/3 of a cup of strawberries. Strawberries, I don't think, are too terribly difficult to cut frozen. But you can let them thaw a little bit if that's easier for you. And you can throw them in here frozen because they're going to sit overnight and they're going to thaw. But enough by the time when you go to eat this tomorrow, it's going to be just fine. So these are pretty solid. But I'm also going to chop my walnuts. And that's just to kind of make them a little bit, spread them out a little more. Because, well, first of all, they're already walnut halves and pieces. So some of them are already chopped. But it gets it distributed through more, I think, than if you have whole walnuts. But again, if you like them whole, keep them whole. You can also use pecans. I mean, this recipe, obviously, you can use any fruit you want. You can use any nut you want. You can skip fruits and nuts. You can use dried fruits. I've tried them a lot of different ways. This one, for some reason, I tend to kind of go back to. I think it's just, it's simple, it's nice, it's tasty, it's, I don't know. Pretty convenient. I've ended up with some that I haven't cared for as much. You could use blueberries in place of strawberries if you like blueberries. Strawberries, I think, are a little sweeter, and again, since we're not adding any sweetener, I think they contribute a bit to that. Sometimes I'll put in pineapple or mango, although I will say those are sweeter fruits. There's nothing wrong with that, but you know, I'm doing 400 calories. So that's kind of why I'm trying to be careful about those kind of things, but I don't necessarily advocate for constant calorie counting. I think it can get to be too much. All right, so I'm going to throw in some of these strawberries, but I'm not going to put them all in just yet, and then I'm going to chop the walnuts and put those in. So we're going to use about a tablespoon and a half of walnuts, which isn't actually that much, but it's enough to kind of distribute it through. So we're going to say like a heaping tablespoon is about a tablespoon and a half. That's probably a little high, but like that. Chop them all. So once again, we have something we have to put in the fridge overnight, so you're not going to be able to eat it right away. But I'll show you one that I did last night so you can kind of see the difference after it's sat overnight and the consistency of it, because that's what it's all about here. When you eat it the next day, you can eat it cold. It's really good that way. But you could also heat it up. So if you prefer your oatmeal hot, just stick it in the microwave. I mean, you know, microwave's maybe not ideal, but it works. Okay, so now I've added most of the strawberries and the walnuts, and I'm going to just keep adding this milk. The milk will just kind of fill in the gaps, and then you can stir it, and I'll just add the last at the very end. And that's really all there is to the recipe. It's that simple. And then we'll put the cover on it, this mason jar, throw it in the fridge overnight. I mean, if you're making it, I mean, I don't know how many hours, you would probably want it to go 5 or 6 hours. For it to be absorbed, but it doesn't have to be overnight if you've got a different situation. Okay. More strawberries. Rest of the milk. And you can see it really just comes right up to the top there. And that banana is going to be all through there. So the consistency of it right now is really liquidy. There's bits and pieces in here, but it's not, but it's runny. Like, you wouldn't probably want to eat it just like this. It's too runny. So I'm going to cover it. Put it in the fridge, and I'm going to pull out the other one. So this is one I did yesterday, exactly the same recipe, much thicker. The oats and the chia seeds have absorbed everything. And if you pick it up, it's like this. It's like an oatmeal consistency. So it's really nice. You can stir it up and make sure everything really got mixed well together. And it's, I think it's easy to eat. Some people, if you use yogurt or something, it'll probably be thicker. If you use, I mean, you can change the proportion slightly of liquid to dry ingredients, but the consistency will just be affected slightly by that. All right, so we're going to look at the numbers here. So calories in this meal is 403. I don't know if you can see. Protein is 10 grams. So for 403 calories, that's really only 10% of our calories from protein. So this is lower in protein. The recommendation is to get 10 to 35% of your calories from protein throughout the day. So we're still at 10%. It's not terrible, but it's a lower protein meal, and that's okay. You know, we know this. We've got 16.9 grams of fat. So I wanted to talk for a second about the fat, because this actually is the same amount of fat that we had in our meal last week, which included like eggs and cheese and stuff like that. So I was actually kind of surprised. I was like, how can this be so high fat? It seems so low fat. We've got oats and fruit, right? So there's two things I want to say about fat. First of all, although this is like 37% I think it's like 37 or 38% of our calories are coming from fat, and the recommendation is to do between 20 and 35% of your calories from fat. The recommendation is like over time, so over the day. So you don't, if you have one meal that's a little higher than in fat, or one meal that's a little lower in protein or something like that, you're gonna balance it throughout the day and frankly throughout your week, you know? So you don't, it's very unlikely that you're gonna get a meal that is like spot on with all of the nutrients you need for the day, all divided up in perfect proportions. It's really, really almost impossible to do that. So don't worry about one meal. You want to kind of look over the course of your day, and sometimes even over the course of the week. So if you have one day where you realize, oh, your calories or your fat intake or something has been high, or your fiber has been low or something like that, then just balance it with some other days in the week. And that's what it's all about. It's about balance and moderation and variety. You know, we need to have some variety. We can't do the same thing every day, even if we found the perfect equation. The second thing I'm going to say about the fat is that the sources of fat in this particular meal, which are mainly the walnuts and then secondarily the chia seeds, although I'll tell you, even oatmeal is not fat-free. These are sources of polyunsaturated fats. We actually, sometimes people tend to be deficient in polyunsaturated fats. We need to get them in our diet, though. They're essential, meaning our bodies can't actually make them. We're talking about our omega-6s and omega-3s. These are, for some reason, we can make a lot of things in our body. Like, we can repurpose parts to make other things. It's actually pretty incredible. But polyunsaturated fats, omega-6 and omega-3, we don't have the enzyme to make that particular structure. Now, there's two other polyunsaturated fats that you may have heard of. These are longer chain, EPA and DHA. And you can actually use some omega-6 and omega-3 and convert them to EPA and DHA. You can also get those from fish. So we need those too, but you can get those from the omega-3s and omega-6s, if that makes any sense. But there's no way we can get omega-3s and omega-6s without eating them. So we need to consume them. So these are actually your good fats that you're getting here. So I think that's just a good thing to remember. There's a significant amount of fat in this meal, so know that. But the majority of it is polyunsaturated fat, which is great. So we've got a lot of that already going for us in the day. And then the final thing is fiber. We've got 14.4 grams of fiber. So the recommendation for fiber is like 25 to 35. So seriously, we have like half our fiber already taken care of in just this first early meal of the day. So that's a lot of fiber. And if you have any questions or concerns or anything like that, please leave that in the comments below. I'd be happy to attempt to answer. And that's going to be it for today. Once again, I'm Lorelei. This has been Nutritionelle. Have a great day.